Okay, so before I start talking about the HIV medications, I wanted to discuss the HIV virus itself a little bit so you can understand how the medications are going to work. Alright, the HIV virus, it's a parasite. This parasite wants to get inside a cell, it wants to take over the cell, and it wants to replicate itself. That's its sole purpose, to complete replicating itself, continually replicate itself. For the sake of this presentation, this is going to represent the virus, the HIV virus, the human immune deficiency virus. And here we have, it has docking proteins. It's got GP41, which are the little sticks you see right here, and the little balls are the GP120. Those are going to be important later to describe how some of the medications work. Basically, how this whole virus is going to get to do its process, it's going to try to find a host cell, but in order to do that, it needs to get into the host bloodstream. And once it does that, it's going to try to find certain cells. It hijacks them. In this case, it hijacks CD4 T cells, which is going to be this. This is going to represent the CD4 T cell. What it's going to do, it's going to try to get its genetic material into the cell so that it can keep replicating itself, because that's its purpose. Okay, for the first category of drugs, I'll be talking about the non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. In this diagram, I'm going to show you where it works. So you get an idea. Basically, the virus wants to get inside the cell, so at this point, it's already inside, and my drug category works right here to inhibit reverse transcriptase. And this works, the reason they're called non-nucleoside reverse is because they're outside of the nucleus. Okay, so reverse transcriptase, that's an enzyme that this virus has, and it uses the enzyme to change its genetic material, the virus genetic material, into human-like DNA, the DNA material in here. So my medication blocks that, and that basically stops the replicating of the virus. Okay, so therapeutic effects that you're going to see in my category and in the following, it's going to be all the same. The therapeutic effects are CD4 T cells count up because those are immune cells, and we want them to be up, and the HIV virus is going to be lower, decreased in the body. Some side effects to non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase are rash, diarrhea, and nausea. Those are basically common. But the most dangerous side effect is Stevens-Johnson syndrome. This is a potentially deadly skin disease, and we can assess for this by flu-like symptoms, fever, malaise, nausea, vomiting, and rash. So contraindications to this category are hypersensitivity, which you're also going to see in the rest of the categories, and they're going to be hypersensitive to a lot of the components of these drug categories, drug medications. Another contraindication in mind is St. John's wort. The use of this can compromise the effect of the medication. My next drug category is entry inhibitors. And basically, unlike NNRTIs, these work outside the cell. Basically, entry inhibitors block or prevent this receptor on the T cell, which is the CCR5, from binding to the stick right here, which represents the GP41. And that prevention doesn't allow the virus to go in, and that's what we want. So the therapeutic effects are the same, increase in CD4, decrease in HIV virus. Some of the common side effects you're going to see are dizziness, abdominal pain, coughing, fever. Something important to keep in mind is to check the blood pressure in that patient, because the dizziness can be caused from orthostatic hypotension, so you want to check blood pressure. The most life-threatening side effect or adverse effect is hepatotoxicity, which can be assessed through liver function tests. Again, the same contraindications include hypersensitivity to any components of the drug. And now I'll leave you over to Taylor, who will discuss the following two categories.
Okay, my category is nucleoside analog reverse transcriptase inhibitors, and they work within the nucleus, right here. And what they do, they inhibit DNA replication. They do this by mimicking the four nucleoside bases of the DNA and basically creating a counterfeit form of DNA so so the HIV covirus cannot replicate itself anymore. Okay, like other drugs, desired effects is going to be CD4 T cells up, HIV provirus down, and some side effects and adverse reactions is hypersensitivity, pancreatitis, and suppression of the bone marrow. That's a very important one. We're going to look at a complete blood count to see if the white and red blood cells are down. Contraindications contraindications for this medication would be severe hypersensitivity. Now with the drug Abacavir, which is within the NARTI category, this allele has been proven that if a patient has this allele within their chromosomes, they will have a severe hypersensitive reaction. And also hepatic impairment is another contraindication. My next category of drugs, integrase inhibitors, what they do is they inhibit the enzyme integrase from within the nucleus during DNA replication. And this is the newest type of drug in all of these categories of medication. It has been proven to work on people who have shown drug resistance. And it's the same therapeutic effects that we want. We want the provirus down and the CD4 T cells up. Okay, so side effects and adverse reactions, they're very simple. A lot of these other drugs have hypersensitive reactions, and this one has not been shown to have a hypersensitive reaction. What it has been shown is diarrhea, headache, and nausea. So contraindications is a severe hypersensitive reaction to any component of these drugs, and the use of St. John's wort. It has been proven to compromise the effectiveness of this drug category. And now I'm going to leave it to Hiram.
Good evening. I'm going to talk about protease inhibitors and fusion inhibitors. The first category that I want to discuss to you is a fusion inhibitors. What fusion inhibitor does? So this drug is going to inhibit the EP41, which belongs to the HIV virus. So when this drug is here, it's not going to allow the HIV virus get into the host cell, which is the CD4 T cell. So basically, this drug works outside the host cell. In other words, it won't allow the CD4 get infected anytime. So now I'm going to discuss to you some of the side effects or adverse effects. Some of them are anxiety, depression, thrombocytopenia, neutropenia, and pancreatitis. As a nurse, we can run different tests as CBC, CMP, CD4 cell counts. Some of the side effects are mentioned already, and some contraindications are
hypersensitivity and breastfeeding.
And now I'm going to talk about the second category, which is protease inhibitors. This category works in a different scenario. So the first one, fusion inhibitors, work outside of the CD4 cell, but protease inhibitors is going to work inside the CD4, which is this one, the CD4. So where does this one work? Once the virus get inside the HIV virus, past the nucleus, when it's replicated, this drug is going to inhibit the enzyme called or named protease. What does this enzyme do? This enzyme works as a scissor. It cuts the genetic material in a specific length, so all the genetic information needed for the replication of the virus will be ready. But when the drugs works in that part, inhibiting the protease enzyme, the genetic material will not be specific, will not be the same, so the replication won't happen. So some of the adverse effects are low hemoglobin levels, intention of suicide, and seizures. Some of the labs that we can run, CD4 T cell counts, hemoglobin levels, and monitor the patient by observing the patient. Some of the contraindications, as we mentioned before, are
breastfeeding and hypersensitivity.
And some of the nursing diagnoses that we can use are social isolation and risk of infection. We are very thankful for your attention.